Hello, good morning all. Today in this video, we are going to discuss regarding how to create a droplet in Digital Ocean. So currently in the screen, I have opened my Digital Ocean account in order to illustrate how to create a droplet in Digital Ocean. So yet if you haven't an account in Digital Ocean, we are adding our referral link right under this video description. So you can just click on that link and claim your $100 free credit. So here you can see we have already get 100 free credits for usage of 60 days, and using this free credit we will be creating and showing you how to create a droplet in Digital Ocean. So here you can see once you logged in, you will have a create button here. So if you click on that, the first option is droplet, create your cloud servers. So I'll choose this option and it will redirect me to another page where we can choose which distribution that I have to install. So currently I'll go with Ubuntu 20.04. You can change the version as per your need from here. So I'll go with Ubuntu 20.04 LTS, and if you need you can choose any one of these. So I'll stick on with Ubuntu, and next you have to choose which plan you have to use. So as beginner we will be using very basic plan, shared CPU basic, which is selected by default. So I'm not going to change this, so I'll go with basic. And if you come down, you will have the option of CPU. So I'll use a regular with SSD option, the disk. And then you will have different options like how much performance you need, like how much RAM you need, SSD and transfer width. So here we have the amount also, that is if you are using a 1 GB and one core processor, it will cost around $5 per month. And if you need 2 GB and one CPU core, it costs 10 per month. And for $15 you will be getting 2 GB RAM plus 2 CPU core and 60 GB SSD disk plus 3 TB transfer. So here what I'll do is that, as we are just illustrating purpose, I'll go with the $10, which is not very bad but very least, because we only have 2 GB RAM with one CPU core, 50 GB. Or what I can say, I'll go with this one. Let me choose at least 2 CPU core, later it will be helpful. So here I'll choose this one, or you can choose one among this according to your plan. So I have selected all the things, that is Ubuntu very basic with $15 plan. And if you come down, then you have to choose which data center region you need to choose. So here you will have options like New York, San Francisco, Amsterdam, Singapore, London, anyone you can choose according to your location. So by default it is set as Amsterdam, so I'm not going to change that, let it be stay the same. So you can choose according to your location from here. Then what we have to do is that we have to set an SSH key or create a password for this cloud server. So we all know that when we normally log into a server, we will have a password. So you can set a password for your droplet here. So just create a password. So I have created a password, and here you can see they have some password requirement condition, must be at least 8 characters long, one uppercase letter, must contain one number and cannot end in a number or special character. So let me type once more, let me enter a password that satisfy all the requirement. I have entered and it says there should be one number, so I have entered the number also, and it cannot be end. So let me, I'm forgetting the password, so let me clear once again and let me create a password. Yeah, I have created a password for my server, so that's done. You can see all this is ticked. Now what we have to do, I'm not going to enable anything, it's asking whether you need a backup monitor, etc. So you can see these are things are free, so you can just stick on that. User data, user data, when you create a droplet to perform task to run script, or you can just activate this. So you can, or you can just keep unticked according to your need. So I'm not going to tick anything. And if you come down, you can see create a droplet. So simply click on that and your droplet will be created in a few seconds. So you can see your droplet is getting created. we have to wait until the loading finishes. So it may take a minute or maybe less. So we will wait until this loading is completed. So I'm repeating once again. So in order to claim your free 100 USD credits, just use our referral link that we have shared in the video description. So you will be getting a free credit of 100 USD for the usage of 60 days. So it's almost finished. Ubuntu is 2 VPU, 2 GB. All the details you can see here. So you can see things loading is finished, and if I click on that, you will be getting all the details over here. So the IPv4 address is this one, copy, and private IP and everything you can see. And let's try to log in now and see. So we have successfully created a droplet, and now I'll try to copy this, and let me check the username. I think it's Ubuntu itself. So let me open my terminal and try to access this project. So SSH root at, I think the username is root, enter new server. I have to enter yes, and it's asking for the password that we have entered there. So I'll enter the password here. And you can see we have successfully logged into the server. You can see the authentication is done, and I have logged into the newly created droplet. Simply enter SSH root at your IP address that we have received here. Just accept yes, then enter the password to log into your server. So this is how we can create a droplet in DigitalOcean. So I hope this video will be helpful for you. If you like the video, please do click the like button and support us by sharing the video with your Odoo friends, and use our link to join the DigitalOcean. So that's it for the day. Have a nice day. Thank you.